Welcome back. Your time now is coming up on 9:17. Moms, stop for a second, okay? Your emotional struggles right now, they're being recognized. Psychologists and labor experts actually agree that the COVID crisis is taking a greater toll on women than men.
And here to dive deeper into this and offer some wonderful advice, mental toughness expert and author Eric Rittmeyer. Good morning, Eric. How are you?
Good morning.
Good morning, guys. Great to see you. Thanks for having me back.
Absolutely. Okay, mom guilt. It's real and it's strong right now. Go ahead and dive into that one for us.
It is, you know, and as parents, we want to assume all the guilt from our children. We feel horrible for them. They're missing out on things. You know, men and women are hardwired differently, and women can really relate emotionally to their kids, and they take on that guilt. They feel bad for the kids. It's a difficult time for everybody, but moms especially feel it 10 times more than the kids do.
And then when it comes down to making assumptions about your kids, what do you mean along that avenue?
Yeah, the assumption is automatically, Leanne, that the kids are really not liking what's happening right now, or maybe they're just emotionally distraught. A lot of kids are, but there are some kids who are really finding some peace in this. You know, maybe kids that were going to school and were bullied, or maybe kids that were feeling separated from their parents. They're now at home. Some kids actually enjoy this environment. They like this better. So we shouldn't automatically assume they're struggling. We have to be aware of that, but they might also be doing better than they were in school. They might be enjoying this extra time with mom and dad.
Kids really kind of do go with the flow sometimes, right?
They can, yeah. Yeah. Let's talk about scheduling, because a lot of people, they want to set it up. They want things to be perfect. You know, they mm-hmm. want to make sure that everything is done just right. And that schedule, I mean, flexibility is key these days.
It absolutely is. And the schedules, Todd, that's the issue. It's like that football game that's played in the blizzard, right? And it's like they're falling over the place. There's fumbles. They're going out of bounds. But eventually they make their way down the field and ultimately they score the touchdown. It's the same thing right now. We have to step back and say, look, it's not going to be pretty, but let's keep in control of what we can keep control of. Everything else, it's going to be okay at the end of the day. We can't put too much mental energy towards it.
And speaking of mental energy, we need to start thinking about what's possible and maybe what's not impossible, those types of things, right?
Sure. Yeah, we put so much emphasis now on the things that we can't do anymore, things that we used to be able to do. And that's a problem. That can really drain us emotionally. So what we have to do is start focusing more energy on what's new. How can we make new experiences? How can we take advantage of the situation that we currently have? So look at what's possible as opposed to focusing on what we can no longer do.
What's realistic? How do we start? If a mom knows her cards are kind of there, but they're just kind of thrown in the air right now. So how one by one do we grab those cards and start stacking our deck a little bit?
Yeah, that's a great question, Leanne. And see, that's the issue, and that's what differentiates men from women and fathers from mothers. You know, it's like those memes where the mom and dad are laying in bed and the mom's little bubble over her head says, are we ready for school tomorrow? Are all the papers in? Is the sporting event okay? And the dad's bubble says, do I like barbecue sauce or honey mustard sauce? You know, so it's like we think so differently, you know, and the moms are normally more in tune with that. They were struggling prior too, so now it's just difficult on them.
And we don't want to leave out the dads. We know dads are struggling, but this, we're just talking about what studies are showing right now, right?
Absolutely, and this is the key. We have to be realistic about this, Leanne. Prior to all this happening, the moms were the ones that were getting the brunt end of the laundry, the cleaning, the pickup, the drop-off, the school forms. That's just the way it was. Not saying dads don't help. They absolutely do. But I keep hearing this, you know, we're all in the same boat. We're really not in the same boat with what's happening right now. We're in the same storm, but we're all in different boats. Some of us came into this with a 50-foot yacht. Others of came in with an inflatable blow-up, you know, tube with a hole in it. So moms especially really, really have a difficult time, especially if they're not getting help from the father.
Now, I got a good group of dads that we rely on each other. We kind of have our own little network that we talk to each other about things that we're going through. And I'm sure moms the same, that mommy network, you got to leverage that in times like this.
You sure do, Todd. Let's call a guy needs is a beer, a pizza, and a remote, and we're good to go, right? And that's all we need. Women, it's a little bit different. You know, I have two teenage daughters. I can't tell you the look, and I can see the pep in their step when they get done with their nail appointment, getting their hair done. These are things moms especially have to rely on other moms. They're going through the same things. We all have different needs here, but we have to make certain that mom is taken care of, because if she's not, the kids are going to get the end of that.
All right. Well, thank you so much. To learn more about this and other mental toughness tips from Eric, and get a free copy of his book, Maximize Your Emotional Intelligence, at mentaltoughnessspeaker.com. Thanks for your time. Great advice.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Sure.
You bet. Hey, now it's time for a health and wellness tip.